moon is so colossal. I wanna grip her like the bottom of the bottle. Drop it down low, bring it up real slow. About to go down, make me say, oh yo. Body like a model, moon is so colossal. I wanna grip her like the bottom of the bottle. Drop it down low, bring it up real slow. About to go down, make me say, oh yo. Drop it down low.
So starting off, we're just going to be applying some primer on our eyes so our eyeshadow stays longer and won't crease. And I am applying my NARS Creamy Concealer in Custard. And I'm just applying a translucent powder to set that primer or the concealer. And moving in, I'm going to be using Sherbert from the palette, and I'm going to be using a big blending brush from Sigma. All of those details will be listed in the bottom bar, and we're just going to be working that into our crease. Next, we're going to be taking hot chocolate on a smaller blending brush from Sigma, and we're going to be putting that on the kind of on our lid and very, very lightly on the crease, kind of working that in. You don't want to apply too much product, so make sure when you put it on your brush to tap off the excess. And with as little product as possible, I'm going to be applying it a couple times just so I can get a good definition into our crease. And you almost want to bring that hot chocolate color a little bit down on the lid as well. As you can see, I'm leaving a space in the center of our eyelids because we are going to be applying a different eyeshadow there. And then going in with that bigger brush, I'm trying to blend it all together. And you want to make sure with this look that you don't have any harsh lines. So blending is such a big part, and especially in these kinds of looks because you're using two different colors. So blend, blend, and blend some more. And going in with our NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk, I'm applying that to the part that we left empty on our lid. This is going to act as a primer as well, and it will also make sure that the eyeshadow comes out really nice and pigmented. And then going in with that color Treasure and just a small shader brush, we're going to be putting that on our lids. So here I'm just going to apply my eyeliner, and I'm using the eyeliner brush from Tarte and my Maybelline gel liner. And I also am going to be doing my eyebrows and my foundation off camera just because it's almost always the same. If you follow me, you know most of the products that I use because they never change. But if you don't and you're a new viewer, then you can go ahead and go to one of my other videos and you can see exactly what I do if you're interested. And regardless, I will have a new eyebrow routine and foundation routine up soon. So I did my face and I used my Born This Way foundation, my Camouflage Kat Von D concealer to conceal any spots or marks, and my Pro LA Girl to highlight under my eyes. I also used this Lip Injection Plumper from Too Faced. I really like it. It gives me a nice plumped lip, especially for this look. I kind of wanted my lips to look a little fuller. I also am baking with my translucent powder from Laura Mercier and my MAC Studio Fix to set my makeup. And of course, gotta curl those lashes, and I apply just a small coat of my Gifted mascara. And we're just gonna be wiping away all the excess powder from our face from that baking. And we're taking this gel liner from ColourPop in Oh Baby. It's like a lavender purpley color. And we're just going to be applying that to the bottom tear duct. And I'm going to be grabbing my highlighter palette from The Balm, and I'm going to be using Cindy Luminizer to highlight. And this is kind of a pinkish highlighter, really pretty, and I'm just going to apply it on the bridge of my nose and then on the top of my contour. Going in with that Treasure, I'm also going to be applying that in the inner corner just to highlight. And just going in with a nude lip liner, I'm just going to be lining my lips. And then going in with this matte lipstick from Smashbox called Be Legendary. It's just a nude lipstick, and we're just going to be putting that all over our lips. And then going in with our blush from NYX called Chiffon, we're just going to be putting that on the apples of our cheeks, and we are done with this look. Let go. Quisiera regresar el tiempo y cambiar errores. Sé que todo fue mi culpa y te causé dolores. So now that we are done with that, we're moving on to the review. And so this is basically what the palette looks like. This is the back of it. It just tells you all of the ingredients and the eyeshadow colors. And you open it and they have a big nice mirror. You can see my phone right there. Anyways, so yeah, they have a nice big mirror. And then moving on to the colors, this is basically what the palette looks like. So it ranges in colors. It has some fun colors, like this one's called Isla, and then this kind of purpley blue eyeshadow, and then it has some more darker ones like this one, and then a black with a shimmery color in it. And so they also have kind of just like transition colors and pinks, grays, so it kind of has a little bit of everything. I really liked this palette because for me, when I look at palettes, I feel like I look at all of the colors. Like, I take into consideration what colors I wouldn't use or what colors I would use. And so I remember going into Ulta and seeing the Lorac 2 Mega Pro palette, and I didn't really like the bottom two rows. I just didn't think that I'd use many colors in the bottom two rows.
And for this one, I felt like I would use all of these colors and, you know, except for this one. This one's not, it's like a really dark gold. So I'm going to swatch all of the colors just for you guys to see what they look like and how pigmented they are. So starting off with the top, I'm going to swatch the pink champagne. And I really like this color. It's like almost kind of like a pigment. And so, hold on a second. So that is what it looks like. Just a really nice, pretty pink, glittery color. Honestly, it would look fab, like such a great pretty color to put like on the lid with like a smoky eye or even a neutral eye. And then moving on to Metallic Plum, which is a color right next to it. I'll actually put them on my hand just so you can see them a little bit better. So this one is Metallic Plum. And like it is, like it says, it's like kind of like a plum burgundy color. Really pretty. And I feel like you could do a lot with this one too. Like especially a nice smoky black, like black with this color, I think would look great. So yeah, that is what Metallic Plum looks like. The Self-Made, which is the gold one that I was talking about, it's kind of like a goldy, orangey, yellow tone. I don't know how to describe it. And that one is right here. So it's not super gold, but it kind of has like a yellow tone, orange tone to it. It is pretty, but I mean, I don't know. I'm not too big of a fan of it, so. And then the next one we're going to be swatching is Witchy, which I haven't used yet, but it's just a nice gray kind of brown tint color to it. That's what that one looks like. And then blush. Now this one's a silver. Well, it looks silver. And actually, now that I'm swatching it on my hand, it kind of has like a tint of pinkish to it. I don't know if you could see that. But that's what it looks like. And then moving on to Blossom, this looks like a pinky purpley color, and I'm like running out of space on my hand here. And this one's really pretty too. Oh, focus. So that's what that one looks like. And then Buttery is just kind of like a brow bone color because it's like a yellow. Oh, I don't know if you can see it. It's right there. I feel like I haven't used this one, but I feel like I would use this one to just highlight my brow bone. I think that would be really pretty. Then we have Deep Purple, which I am so excited to use this color because this one is like my favorite. It looks like a purpley brown and, or purpley, I keep saying brown and like, that one is what it looks like. So it's purpley blue. It's called Deep Purple. If you guys want another look recreated with this palette, definitely thumbs up or leave a comment. And then Treasure is a, let me wipe off my hand because I'm like running out of space. Moving on, guys, sorry, my hand's too small. I couldn't fit all of those colors on there. And so I already did that top row, and then moving on to the bottom row, I already did Deep Purple. So we're moving on to this color right here called Treasure. And this one I use for the inner corner highlight just because it's a really pretty sparkly kind of like champagne color. So that's what it looks like. And honestly, I feel like you could even use this as like a regular highlighter for like your cheekbones. It's really pretty. Then moving on to Hot and Cold, this one's kind of like a copper color, and that's what it looks like. And then Sherbert, I love this color. This is like my go-to transition color. Like, it is life, this one. Kind of like a peach color. This is another one that I want to try, Isla. It's like a minty green color. That's what it looks like. And moving on to Spirit Rock. So this is a black one. This is a black shadow, but like I said, it has a little bit of glitter in it, and it's like pink glitter, pink purpley glitter. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it, but maybe? No. I don't know if you guys can see the glitter in it. And then moving on to hot chocolate, this is just kind of a deep brown cocoa color. I really like this one too. And that is what hot chocolate is. It kind of does remind you of hot chocolate, especially in this cold weather. Perfect. Also, a brush comes in it, but I totally misplaced it. I swear to God, guys, I misplace everything. And that's where it was, and it's just kind of a two-sided brush, and it has like a small, like a smaller blending side and then kind of like a bigger blending side. So, I mean, I used it. It works pretty well. So, yeah, for $35 is how much I paid for this on the Anastasia Beverly Hills website, which I will link down below. And if you guys want to check it out, I highly recommend this palette. You can make so many looks with this, like endless, endless looks with this. And it's just all really pretty colors, not too crazy for those of you who just don't really like experimenting or just kind of stick to regular colors. Because during winter, I kind of feel like I stick to browns and blacks. And so, yeah, like, I mean, this, the only crazy colors or colors that I think some people would be intimidated by would be that deep purple and then Isla. But like I said, endless creations with this palette. So if you guys are wanting to buy it or thinking about buying, I definitely recommend it. I think it's totally worth $35 for, you know, most palettes these days are like 50 and above. And so yeah, for $35, this is definitely worth it. But yeah, anyways, I hope that was helpful. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and this review. Thumbs up if you liked it. Thumbs up if you want another look recreated with this palette. Let me know if you want a certain look or if you saw a certain look on Instagram. I know I've been seeing a ton. So yeah, definitely let me know, and I will see you guys in my next video. You know, I wish my bun would come out like this all the time, because there's days where I can't. My hair does not cooperate. Am I crazy because I talk to a camera? No, right? No. I'm not the only one.